3, 2, 1. Hi, I'm Michael Farabee for Arrested Mod Mics, and today we have royalty here. You'll just have to pardon me, this is chair's kind of squeaky, so, and nothing ever goes good. This is always live, this isn't Memorex. This microphone, we've done plenty of these, but we haven't done one like this. And so the deal being is that this is an Altec 639A, which would mean from the later 40s. But this microphone was one of the microphones that was on the Grand Ole Opry, the original one, the Mother Church building, when it first started. And this is a pleasure for us to do this mic here. This mic worked fine. It's in pristine shape with the original yoke, the whole nine yards, and it just has the ability to be everything it can be. It's like it was in a time capsule. But the dynamic element in the bottom was not working due to the time period and how many years, and the magnet took a dive because of the magnetivity, and the magnet on the dynamic element in the bottom part of this left the building. So this microphone had never been apart. I always have a way of knowing whenever I open one of these up. And this one was frozen in a time capsule, apparently. There's only two of these that were left, and it was given to one. One was given to my customer, which is this mic, and another one to another gentleman that he knew, a friend of his. And so this microphone, we hated to even go into it, but he wanted it working. So I said, okay, well, I happen to have one in my collection. I finally dug through the files and I found an original one to take its place. Normally we have to put a more modern updated one in here. And but on this, we saved it for such a time as this. And this is a piece of history here I'm talking on. And you'll hear the ribbon kind of slack every now and then whenever, and the P words, because I don't have a filter on the front, like a pop filter. But this microphone is still grand, and it's from the Grand Ole Opry days. And all the people, I imagine, and I've seen all the pictures and seen all the older black and white videos of the performers on the Grand Ole Opry singing on these mics. These and the RCA 44 and the 77s were the main mics for them to sing on back in those days. And I must say they had good taste in equipment then. And that was very, very long ago, 30s, 40s, and 50s, and 60s, and so on and so forth. But the microphone has survived, and it will go back to the gentleman who owns it. I hate to see it go, but hey, I can't take him with me. But I can imagine all the country stars who stood in front of this, maybe this mic here or the other one. But this mic here gives me great pleasure to think about that anyway, if it happened. And people like, Hank Williams Sr. and Patsy Cline and Loretta Lynn and those people like that. And way back before they ever changed out to the newer gear back in the 50s and 60s, mainly in the 60s, I think they changed over. And they started using, I think, more of the RCA mics. Be it, like WSM radio and all that kind of stuff was completely changed over somewhat then. But this microphone is just, it's a museum piece, what can I say? And you had, stuff like, people like Jim Reeves and people like that sing on it. And I'm going to put some reverb on this thing and we'll see here a minute. Testing 1, 2, and we'll come back, check, testing, there we go. Now it kind of sounds like the concert hall, so, but Jim Reeves would be like, four walls to hear me, four walls to see, four walls to hear me, closing in on me. So that's a Jim Reeves thing here in WSM Radio in Nashville. Tennessee, and Mother Church Grand Ole Opry, and you'd have people like Hank Sr., you know, and he'd be like, "Hey, hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me?" So people like that, and many, many more. All the grand old ones are little Jimmy Dickens and people like that, and Jim Ed Brown and those guys. But mainly the ones from way back, their pictures, a lot of the pictures that you would see, they were standing behind this mic probably. So, but it's a great pleasure and thinking about it. But we got it all put back in, and we didn't have to do much else. But it is a big job. The whole floor and the insides have to come completely out of this mic to even get to the dynamic element in the bottom end of this thing. So, and we've been doing these a long time. We've done hundreds of them, and we're still doing them today. So if you like this video, you know, click the subscribe button at the bottom, the big red one. And we hope you guys appreciate what we do. We're just trying to keep a piece of history alive and keep going. And we're very thankful for you guys. And don't want any negative comments, no cursing on the site. If so, they'll be taken off. And we're a family-run thing here. We're Christian people, so I'm proud of it. But anyway, just wanted to share this mic with you guys, and I hope you appreciate it like I do. And may the Lord bless you and take a liking to you in a mighty way. And you guys be safe out there. We'll see you next time on the tube. And